When he awoke, there was a branch of silver by him with white blossoms on it. He took it home with him, and later when all were assembled, a beautiful woman appeared in their midst, arrayed in a ring of precious orange. These are the words he spoke as the bards relate. Half sees out of the bright sea, half suffer about my own land. It's borne by fourfold noble columns, where the waves and the deep sky are joined. White of day on the brave reward, plain of the sea where hosts contend, battle bouts of boats and chariots, and fine plain south of the silver land. Columns of white bronze beneath me, delight and light of numbered worlds, home of countless beyond life's thought, where blossom blooms and flowers fly. There is a tree of flowers, there perch the birds of melody, calling together each changed hour with perfect and habitual harmony. Hues of every tint, tune, enchanted chant of woman singers, habitual joy to harp sound, and the pine's swift tremor.
Yeah. San Francisco Bay, Oakland. Well, it's very nice for us all to be back here in your town again. Tonight's a very special night for us, and as we go through the evening, we're going to try and take you through some of the changes that have developed, some of the new things that have happened between Jimmy and I and the rest of us in the last 12 months. To do that, we're calling upon the great skills and charms of some new friends and some old friends. So, Oakland, how about giving one of them warm welcomes yet again on bass guitar to Mr. Charlie Jones? It's a great pleasure to have with us the Manly Hall of the percussion world. Would you welcome the king of the occult bookshops, Mr. Michael Lee? We're very privileged to have traveling with us, floating along with us, a gentleman who is a fan and member of one of the most important British groups of the 80s. Would you welcome from The Cure, Mr. Paul Thompson? next song is, it's a song that, I guess, from what we know, began its life in 17th century Britain and was brought with the conquest of North America by the English to Virginia. It traveled up the Mississippi Valley and back to England and came out like this. As the night opens and develops, it's time to introduce you to another new friend. He's bringing with him an instrument that I guess had its origins in France in the 11th century. Maybe for the first time in this kind of situation, in this state, since this state began, would you welcome on Hurdy-Gurdy, Mr. Nigel Eaton. little song that, this is a kind of cover version of a cover version. Let us offer this song tonight to the great glory and the passing of vinyl. What a vacuous thing to say.
Thank you.
pictures, because in the end it was like saying, being some kind of host for the evening. I'd rather say nothing like everybody else does. But I'm chosen to do this, so I'd like to introduce to you a real close friend of mine, a guy who's growing every day in his awareness of the keyboards. He's moving on to a dual manual now and using both hands. Would you welcome with the Oakland Symphony Orchestra, Mr. Ed Sherman. Thank you. again and to work together to expand what we're doing. It's a great time for us in our career to be able to work with people from different cultures, musicians who we've admired for a long time, from music and from cultures that have always impressed us, and we try to show in the music over the years, both together and individually. So it's a great honor to have us tonight, traveling with us from North Africa, from Cairo, one of the finest musical troops in North Africa. Give a warm welcome to the Egyptian Pharaohs. Oakland, Cairo, Cairo, Oakland.
luck, folks. Let's hear it for the orchestras. Can you feel it?
Thank you.
7, 8, 9. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a great night. No more have I ever seen none more smiles. So many smiles. And all that, and look, here's Nigel. Long live music. Good night and lots of love.